Once again, the night was perfect for pointing one of the lenses best designed by humans towards the stars. Maneuvering this lens at over 2,000 meters in height, on the summit of one of the South American mountains, is a small group of astronomers. The curiosity of these individuals led them to spend endless nights in this place, expecting to confirm something incredibly phenomenal: the existence of a planet orbiting Proxima Centauri, the closest star to the Sun. The movement of the planet around its star causes a periodic oscillation. Every 11 days, a revolution is completed, and the effect on the red dwarf is recorded by the team. For weeks, the telescope has been pointing in the same direction, and for weeks, the same signal is recorded. The pioneers of this distant new world are preparing to write about their discovery and share it with everyone. The scientific community receives the news, and the interest is enormous. In a place not as distant as the vast majority of celestial bodies, there is what could be a second home in an unpredictable future. Furthermore, this little corner in space is located in the habitable zone of its sun, where other forms of life may have developed. Exotic species whose molecular intricacies science might not be able to explain. The imagination of some of the greatest thinkers in the world sails through the possibilities the new discovery unlocks. A distance of 4 light years might be within our reach through technology. So, renowned scientists and powerful individuals join forces to create one of the most ambitious projects in human history. The breakthrough Starshot Project is already in its embryonic phase. Twenty years have elapsed since the unveiling of Proxima B. The leader of the astronomers is now actively involved in the engineering initiative striving to reach the planet, and he has become a key spokesperson for the media. In a television interview, he is asked to explain the project, which is set to take its first step in the coming week. The words spoken by the scientist in the following moments would be heard by the entire world, not only by the scientific community, but also by the billions who listen as if to a prophet. 2 decades ago, I was with my team looking at numbers on a computer, hoping to discover something new in the sky. Something that may not seem so surprising when we have already cataloged millions and millions of stars and galaxies. Our search, however, was for something much smaller and harder to find: planets around other stars. It's essential to understand that these are tiny compared to the fiery ball that illuminates them. At times, it would be like comparing the size of a marble to that of a large yoga ball. And this, ignoring that stars emit light with the same intensity as billions of lamps combined. Perhaps even more, while a planet only reflects that light partially. At the moment, we cannot directly observe an exoplanet, but fortunately, we have other methods. However, there is something even rarer than an exoplanet. That would be an exoplanet in the habitable zone of its star, as is the case with Proxima B. Naturally, we had to find a way to study this place in detail. The Starshot project will send the mothership into a high-altitude Earth orbit. The mothership carries about 1,000 small spacecraft, each only a few centimeters in diameter. After being released, the spacecraft will deploy their sails, covering an area of over 10 square meters. Here on Earth, a matrix with the most powerful lasers ever created is already set up, pointing towards the skies. It will be the combination of all these lasers that will propel the spacecraft and provide them with a ridiculously astonishing speed of 20% of the speed of light. Spectacular! It really feels like we're living in a science fiction movie, says the interviewer, genuinely surprised. She hadn't interrupted the monologue earlier because in the face of so much information and given the importance of this conversation, she didn't want to disrupt it with trivial questions. She intended to keep the interview in a scientific yet understandable tone. She continued, "At such a speed, the journey will undoubtedly take very little time." Indeed, this speed, the spacecraft will reach Proxima Centauri in just a few decades, 20 or 30 years. 50 years ago, no one thought that we could reach such a distant star within a lifetime. When there's no need to put a human inside the spacecraft, the possibilities become much more broad. We can shrink our missions to a few centimeters. Accelerating something so small is obviously much less expensive. And of course, we don't have to worry about the survival of the crew. This spacecraft survives on the energy of a few milligrams of plutonium serving as fuel. The monologue had to be interrupted again. Men of science very easily start to digress. "Indeed, it's impressive," says the interviewer, intending to steer the discussion in a different direction. "So, am I correct in assuming it will be another 20 years for the return?" "In fact, there is no return. We have no way of bringing the small spacecraft back," says the scientist, aiming to create astonishment, something he achieved. "Instead, the photos taken by them will be sent to us. something that will take only 5 years to reach us, because the signal that carries them will travel at the speed of light. It's true, many of us will still be here to see the results of all this effort. Here is, to me, the beauty of it all. I am extremely curious. So, what is expected to be observed in these images? Well, we know very little about this planet, actually. We can't point telescopes at it and draw conclusions like we do with Jupiter, for example. Only recently have we been able to decipher its atmospheric composition. However, we do know that the concept of a day probably doesn't exist on Proxima B. The planet always has the same face turned towards its star. We also know that 1 year there is equivalent to only about 11 Earth days. The gravitational force is slightly stronger on the surface of Proxima B than on Earth, but nothing extreme, just a few extra kilos. The dimensions between the two planets are also very similar. However, Proxima B is only 5% of the Sun-Earth distance from its star, which is not too drastic because the star, being a red dwarf, emits much less energy than the Sun, so much so that negative temperatures are expected on the surface. Then I suppose you wouldn't advise me to go there, the interview says to lighten the weight of all the technical details. The scientist laughs. I would wait a few more years indeed. In fact, it won't be long before we have real estate agents interested in the matter. It's a summer day, no clouds in sight. A rocket stands tall over 100 meters above the landscape of an American desert. Those watching the event from home hear the countdown. The rocket takes off, and in a few minutes, it becomes a dot disappearing into the warm blue sky. Hours pass, and it is broadcasted that the mothership is already in a stable orbit. All systems are checked, waiting for the exact moment. The mini spacecrafts are released and follow the same orbital movement. The main ship moves away. A flash from Earth's surface pierces the atmosphere and reaches the spacecrafts. This line can be seen hundreds of kilometers from where it is emitted and seems to extend infinitely. 10 minutes have passed since the light turned on and went out forever. The spacecrafts have already accelerated to their maximum speed and are heading towards their destination. None have been lost in the process. So far, the mission is a success. There is no control over the spacecrafts now. Free photons traversing the universe will undoubtedly encounter them and provide even more speed. Years pass, and little is known about the progress of the mission. Public interest dwindles. People, little by little, forget about the mission. One day, 26 years after departure, the first images of the new system and stars it comprises reach Earth. The photos were taken from a distance, but a clear distinction can already be made. Small whitish circles against a black background. The 623 spacecrafts that reached the system sent a collection of tens of thousands of images that became the focus of all news outlets for months. The mission leaders explained in interviews that the deceleration process could take more than 10 years. Close photos of Proxima B would have to be awaited for even longer. There is a general dissatisfaction among the public. Everyone expected immediate results. The astronomer is already retired. However, he maintains patience and waits calmly for the outcome of the adventure. He expected this discontent from people. He knew that the world waits for nothing, and there are a few who look at discovery out of pure curiosity. Only the moment matters, the prestige, and all the trivialities created by a system that rewards the worst in human nature. Thousands of images are being received at the mission base every day over weeks. The complex surface of Proxima B is mapped in maximum detail. It is rocky and arid, with some volcanoes. The atmosphere is clear and somewhat cloudy. The predominant color is red, resembling a mixture of Earth and Mars. The mission is once again the focus of the world and the scientific community. Thousands of astronomers prioritize the processing of mission data in their work. Even more computers are utilized for the same task. Techniques for analyzing planetary surfaces and atmospheres are highly sophisticated. In a matter of months, all the information that can be gleaned from the images will be organized, and theories regarding the formation and evolution of the exoplanet will be published. Then, 19 days after the first images of the planet, one of the spacecrafts that had been lost is found again. The team handling the processing of the raw signal found it peculiar, but started to analyze it. This process is initially done automatically by computers and later studied visually for errors and inconsistencies. The surprise is immense when the revealed images not only far, far short of expectations, but also showed something unsettling. It is the figure of a star, very close, occupying more than half of the screen, but it isn't Proxima Centauri. The brightness and colors are not correct. In the following minutes, new images from this spacecraft appear on the team members' screens. Each image reveals a slightly different panorama. The star moves away from the camera. At the same time, the spacecraft seems to rotate, gradually revealing the bodies around it. After 2 minutes, an image appears where the star is no longer present. The spacecraft's camera is pointing in the opposite direction. What clearly stands out in the picture is the entire illuminated hemisphere of a planet, a large blue circle in the center of a black rectangle. It's unbelievable what they are witnessing. The photographs are taken and sent almost immediately. At least that's what the data accompanying the image files indicate. So, if that blue circle is indeed Earth, the spacecraft would have made the Sun-Earth journey at a speed faster than light. The order is given to point several telescopes to the sky in search of the lost spacecraft. The latest trajectories suggest that the spacecraft is orbiting Earth at a distance slightly greater than that of a space station. Telescopes locate the spacecraft through the signal it emits. Days later, all the orbital characteristics of the object are concluded with great precision. No one understands the significance of the event. This spacecraft was part of the fleet that reached Proxima Centauri. It had transmitted images of the star a decade earlier. Surely, it must have been a computational error. It couldn't have returned to Earth by chance. The probability of such an event is minuscule. It would also mean that it made the return journey in half the time of the outbound trip. That would be impossible. It must be one of the spacecrafts that were lost in the early stages of the mission. Similarly, its return to Earth would be extremely unlikely. The spacecraft is to be recovered. Quickly, the mission leaders direct resources and devise a plan to reach to it. After 5 days, construction begins on the vehicle that would be used to reach to it, a spaceship manned by an astronaut. 12 days later, the spaceship takes off. As soon as it arrives at the laboratory, the recovered spacecraft is disassembled into its various components. The sail is slightly damaged, as expected. The other parts appear intact, at least physically. Possible chemical compounds on spacecraft surfaces are sought. There are no conclusive results. The analysis of memory is conducted. It would be expected to find images of its journey stores. From this, it might be possible to recover images that had not been sent to Earth during the period when connection was lost. All the images had been deleted. Recovering the spacecraft seemed to have been in vain. However, amidst all the files and codes that function as the spacecraft's brain, one stands out. There's a loose text file that was not programmed by the mission team. The person responsible for memory analysis is called in. He looks at the computer screen with a puzzled expression. Perhaps this was a source of errors. The programming of this spacecraft had been poorly executed. With some curiosity, he opens the file. His eyes widen. It's a text. He began to read. You have reached the stars. It is indeed a milestone. That and other conquests assure us that it is time for contact. We are all inside a bubble. Could you imagine if we would not get along? It would be disastrous, right? There's nowhere to go. Well, inside your little bubble, things are not going great. It seems you cannot make progress without destroying and abusing living beings. Even your own. We could do the same to you. Transform Earth into a zoo, for example. You have seen what we are capable of. And that is just the tip of the iceberg. But we chose not to. Instead, we chose to let you evolve and make all the mistakes. However, you have gone too far now. Our community hit the pinnacle of evolution some time ago. To do so, we had to understand that selfish and greedy species that focus on the elitism of a few end up by colliding with themselves and destroying others. Through war, we had to eliminate their leaders and their armies to make them a part of us. It was a necessary measure. Now, we reform less advanced species, like yours. You are not capable of governing yourselves with the best well-being of your species as a goal. There are limits to what one can accomplish and discover in this bubble. And we have found them. These are the same limits that separate us from the outside. We are bound to live inside them, the same way we limit the characters in our own simulations.
So, we propose that you let us help you grow as a species. From there, you will understand the real nature of our universe and make peace with it by joining our utopia. This is just a discreet message to give you a warning for what's to come. We cannot take the risk of letting you loose and destroy what we have accomplished. We respect all life forms, and thus, we have worked endlessly to build a peace between worlds from which you have benefited until now. At the same time, the file was opened. The same text contained in it was received on all devices that were being used by human beings at that moment. 5 years later, a flash of blue light illuminated the skies worldwide, marking the beginning of a new era.